Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Today we're back in Men of War Assault Squad 2 on the German skirmishes or campaign or whatever you want to call it. And now we're on the fourth mission, Saint Hilaire. So let's get in there. So far we've had a defensive mission, two offensive missions. It seems to be standard protocol with the skirmishes in Men of War. I've actually been playing a lot around with mods, especially single player ones, so I'll try and bring you some of the content from them. There's one mod which is focused completely on single player and it makes the missions absolutely hectic. Like there's two sides, so there's you and an AI partner, and then on the other side you have two enemies and they come at you with basically everything they have. And you go at them with basically everything you have. There's paratroopers dropping from the skies, there's airstrikes coming in, there's just tons of troops everywhere, and it knocks your frame rate down to about 5 because there's so much stuff going on. But it's bloody brilliant. Anyway, let's get in here. Well, I suppose that kind of makes sense. But anyway, we're at Saint Hilaire. Wherever the hell that is.
It is good to see you again, Herr Oberstleutnant.
Good to see you too, brother.
And have pause to regroup. We must strike before they've assembled enough forces to continue their southern advance. Lead the counterattack, Oberstleutnant.
Why do you sound American? But anyway, we're going to push back with these troops right now. We might as well give them a bit of ammo before they go forth into their deaths trying to take this point, while our secondary pieces of armament, our support units of the mortar and the MG come in. There we go. So we need to capture the central part once again to basically get armored support, which is fine. We'll set up our mortar, a machine gun in a decent place, backed up by these lucky fellas. We'll push forward. Another thing we need to sort out is getting another infantry battalion in to at least put pressure on the people that we are trying to kill, if not move forward themselves. Now, looking at cover, we don't really have anything until we're right next to the enemy, so that's not good for us. That's really bad for us, actually, so it might be worth trying to go through these bushes or something. We're going to fire with the machine gun just to try and pick off as many people as we can before we move forward. It seems like they are entrenched pretty hard here, but that's completely fine. We'll always have troops to shoot at, which is always nice. Something we can do is move over to this bush to push forward. And it looks like our mortar, in its wonderful ways, is not hitting anything as usual. But our infantry are into the battle now, with their Car 98 mainly, it looks like. We don't even have an MG42 with these guys, or an MG34, which is very sad. But it's not the end of the world. Move over to this place over here, get down, and try and pick off as many people as possible. We haven't lost anybody yet. We have a few members who are quite low in health, but luckily, with the squad that we brought in, we'll have a medic. So that's good for us. We'll be able to at least hold them back while they try and kill us. Our MG is providing beautiful cover for our troops moving forward, but right now we just need to take out some of the stragglers who are left. There's only a few guys left here, so a mortar is perfect for trying to at least hit them from their positions, where they are pretty much dug in at this point. And it looks like SMGs are the deal for the day for these guys, or carbines, which is very nice. Something we should do is heal our boys just to make sure that they're at full health so we can push forward. It's always better pushing forward with full health than half health, for obvious reasons. You can take a lot more hits and everything like that. And what we'll do is, when this guy's healed up to full, we'll stick him right here to try and cover what's going on. We'll move up the machine gun as well to cover, and the mortar still in a safe place, but in a position where it can attack. Another thing we can do is push up these guys to here, so they provide at least some support to our guys on that side, so we can push them forward. We'll get these guys in the best position to shoot, also with the machine gun to provide them cover. The mortar's in a decent position already. We'll get it to fire some mortars down the line to help out. We're taking this position, which is wonderful, which will give us something. Probably an armored unit, something I usually don't use. I don't usually use the first one of this just because it's usually not too good. Let's see what it is. Yeah, see, it's an armored car, and an armored car's not really going to do a lot. In the grand scheme of things, especially for me. We'll move over this squad to here so they can get shots on that side. This squad is going to have to stay here. We're actually going to move them up one trench, so it's easy for our guys to get on this machine gun. Go on, son. That's a grenade, but don't worry about it. And hopefully this machine gun here will at least push back the enemy. Now, where's the other machine gun? It's on the other side, so it's an easy run for our guy who wants it. And everybody else can move up. Oh, there's a guy right there. What's he doing? Just throw a grenade. Let's get him out of his cover so we can easily take him out. Two grenades, maybe a bit of overkill. But at least we got some good hits on him. Move these guys up to here to basically spot out for the machine gun. And as we can see, a Willy's MB has decided to try its luck and completely fail. We'll move over the mortar to the center point. To help out our troops who are trying to push that way. We'll also move over the machine gun to do exactly the same thing. And hopefully, it does a good job of pushing. The armored car at this point would be very useful, just to push forward. But to be honest, I think a squad of infantry is cheaper and does exactly the same job. We have support from our machine gun. We have support from our mortar when it gets into position. So I don't really see the need for something like an armored car, especially when it's going to be useless past this point. I mean, it's going to be brilliant for, you know, good old 5 minutes or so, but apart from that, it's going to be quite shoddy, because we all know that they have guns back here, which will take it out. So it's kind of useless in that way. But anyway, we're firing mortars, we're throwing machine gun bullets everywhere, we're even firing the good old Car 98 to see what we can pick out, and nothing is really going on right now. We're just chilling and blood spilling. Move these guys back to make sure they're maxed out of ammunition when we move them forward. Something we can actually do with these guys is move them to this trench, which will be easy to do for them. So, go, go, go. Hopefully none of them die when they're crossing this. We do have the machine gun to cover them, but at this point it doesn't seem to be that anybody actually wants to fire from that. We do want to move up this infantry squad to here, though, to cover the side. And then we'll have nice coverage. There is a lot of guys over here, though, so they're going to have at least a decent battle on their hands when they come up there. Machine gun in itself is doing a wonderful job. It's still pinning people down. There aren't a lot of people left around this point. A lot of them are focused on the right side over here. And so the mortar and the machine gun, which we will bring up. And oh my god, okay, that's quite a lot of bullets coming in, but we're alright, nobody's died yet. We're being quite aggressive with this squad. I don't think it's wrong in saying that, since as you can see there's just a ton of stuff coming in. But we'll move up you to here. We need to put pressure on that right side, so we'll push up these guys to here, and we'll see what we can do. Try and take out the men on this point so we can push up, which is exactly what we'll do, and try and take this point, and then we can focus on this right side where a lot of this fire is coming from. We haven't lost anybody from this side, which actually surprises me. The mortar has decided it's actually better to settle down and live in this bloody house than actually fire. So get up and let's get moving through the tree, wonderful stuff. And through the little crack. Awesome! There you go. There's a nice arc of fire. Let's see what else we can bring in. A Stug. Now, is it worth waiting for the Stug? I think it's worth waiting for. So, what we'll do is, first of all, as usual, get people on these machine guns so we can do damage to anybody around. And let's see. Moving to this one may be a bit of a pain. Hopefully he doesn't die. But he should be alright. We'll move our guys over to support him. But over here, a lot of men have died. which is great for us, because it basically means that, oh my god, get in the trench. There we go. It basically means that it'll be easier to push when we have to. This infantry squad is quite redundant in this position, so I think it's worth moving them up to there. The mortar needs to push up, so does the machine gun, to actually be useful. And now we can bring in a STUG number 3. And we're going to have to micro these guys once again, because obviously houses aren't their strong points. Here we go. Oh, stuck on a lamppost. And now on a well. Come on, boys. Here we go. Sorry, I'm just concentrating quite a lot because, well, these guys just get stuck all the time. And as we can see, it's stuck. Wonderful. There we go, right. Well done, boys. Now, let's see what's coming down the central lane. We have a Greyhound that we should worry about, but we do have a Stug coming in, which should easily be able to deal with it. Hopefully it doesn't do too much damage before the Stug gets there, otherwise we may have a bit of an issue. Come on, boys. You can do it. So the Stug's here to stay. It's loading AP to hit that Greyhound, which is decided to come in backwards. Now, if you are ever driving a Greyhound, or you are going to attack an enemy, driving him backwards, not a great idea. I'm not sure a lot of people would say that is worth it, unless you're driving the goddamn Archer, where basically you have to drive backwards to get your gun to face him. What a stupid machine that was. But anyway, we're moving on to the third point. And there is a Willy's Bee. Is it going to get hit? Or are they just going to leave it to machine guns? Looks like machine guns are the order of the day. Or a HE shell.
Brigade headquarters grants you additional resources and access to the veteran Tiger as a reward for your progress.
Right, so we have access to a veteran Tiger, and now basically the question is, do we save up for it? And to be honest, it's a veteran Tiger, so yes, of course we're going to. It outclasses anything that they can throw at us. If we look up here, if we can, we have a Sherman coming in, so the Stug should be able to deal with us. We also have a bunch of guys who have... who have AT grenades and stuff like that, and through these little streets and stuff, it should be easy to take out a Sherman. But we will wait for the 1,000 points. I think that's a good idea. And sorry, my voice is hurting quite a bit, so... I'll try, I'll struggle through, but I might not talk as much as usual. It's a good hit from the grenade, taking out two guys. And that basically means that the defense of that area is gone, so they can't really do a lot. Something that we do have to look at is obviously this M4A3 coming in. And as long as it doesn't get that good of a shot off, we should be alright in the area on the right. But it all depends on what it wants to go for. If it comes straight down the streets, we can easily get an AT grenade off. We will move our guys back, just so there's no easy targets for him, apart from that machine gunner, if he feels like going for it. Down the center, nothing's really going on, we're just holding firm. And as we can see, the Sherman has no regard for the wonderful architecture of this place, and therefore will die. And there goes the whole crew. Oh no, there's one guy left, go on. Yeah, there's no repairing that, buddy. I think it's dead. We'll throw a grenade at him, just to get him out. And, of course, we'll go right next to him, because that's what you have to do to throw a grenade. And we use the tank for cover while he blows up. But there we go, that's the Sherman dealt with. As easy as possible. Now, something we do need, actually, is what I'm thinking. We'll get some infantry over here. Just to be able to push forward. But apart from that, there's not really a lot to do apart from wait for the Thousand Tiger. I know bringing in more troops means that, you know, we have to wait a little bit longer, but I've got to get something going on, otherwise their defenses are just going to get better because they have more troops coming in. We'll get all these guys ammoed up and then we'll move them in to push on the left flank since it seems quite encased, so moving infantry through it should be quite easy. The center is locked down. The right side is kind of locked down. It could be better. We do have infantry moving in, but we do have guys covering it, including two machine guns. So that should be completely fine. These guys will be completely ammoed up now, so we'll push them up. With the support of our machine guns and our infantry as well, so they'll be completely fine. All these guys behind the Greyhound. That'll be a wonderful shot for the for the mortar, so why not have a go? We might as well try and dislodge them. Oh, he killed somebody. And here comes the squad. The confident squad, which has to go through all this gunfire just to survive. It is a worry, but so far... Ooh... Okay, they got into position, which is good, but they are under heavy fire right now. They can take out at least a few of these men. They should be in a much better position, which seems to be the case. They also have backup fire from behind them, so this should be alright. We have another Greyhound coming in. Coming down the left flank. Right flank, sorry. Or he's backing up like the other one. Silly Billy. And that's that dead. We have another Willy's Bee coming in, and well, that's not really going to do a lot. The only thing it might do is kill these two guys who are under heavy pressure. So we're going to move them, just so we can get them healed up. And so they're not the focus of attention of the gun, which is looking straight at them. But the guys on that Willy's Bee are nearly dead. What I'm going to do, I'm going to focus a lot of my attention on this left flank. Just try and push this Tiger up there and move progressively, slowly across the left. I think that's a good idea. But we have nearly got it, which is nice. And there we go, that's all the men on that dead. So what we can do is push up. Holy crap. Okay, there's a guy right there. He needs to die. Come on, buddy. Close but no cookie. We've got to finish him off. Fine, move up. Here we go. We're bringing in the veteran Tiger as well. Sort that out. And we are getting shot quite heavily from over here. So we should be alright. That's killed a monumental amount of people, but not the medic, so we can get them all back up, which is lovely. So medic, get them up. Come on. Get them firing. And there we go. Wonderful, right. So let's get them into a position where they can actually cover themselves. And up. Down goes Fatty. Let's get him back up. Go on. You've had a few too many drinks, so there you go, that's that sorted. The veteran Tiger is here and here to stay, so it'll get some more rounds as it passes this, but it doesn't really need any right now. 51 and 27 is pretty good, including nearly 3,000 machine gun rounds, which will be very useful at taking this point. We have basically taken it, which is good. We've at least forced the enemy back, which is what we're looking for. You have stopped shooting, so you must have hit something, which is always nice. But how about, you know, you take another shot to try and take out as many men as possible who are trying to keep us back. we'll push up on this point now just to take it. We have actually taken this without really realizing, which is nice, and that gave us a Wurbelwind, which is going to be completely useless, but with the Tiger in tow, we're going to have some very good armor supports all around here. The Tiger, hopefully, is going to go where I tell it to, and we should easily be able to push forward from this point. Move you guys out to there. Get a rifleman with full health on this machine gun. And another rifleman. Oh my god, okay. There's guys there. Shoot him. Tiger, load HG, shoot him all. Need to get those guys up. Hopefully that doesn't include the medic. There is a Sherman coming in. I'm not too worried about that. You loaded AP, I told HE. Doesn't matter. We've killed that guy. And there we go, they're all dead. So, we still have the medic, which is lovely. So we'll move these guys in over here. Keep this gate closed. I'm not even sure if we can open it or not. But we need to... Oh, there we go, open by itself, how lovely. We need to get these guys back up. We don't want to really lose many men. Just because it makes defending all these points a hell of a lot harder. So there we go. We have a rifleman over there, so we'll put him there. And there is a brave soul who decided to try and push down over there, but that's not going to go too well for him. Good shot onto nothing as usual. There's a Sherman on this side that we have to worry about. Crew is injured by something. Probably the Tiger shooting is. Yep. The Tiger's shooting, its engine is damaged. It's a 76, we do have to worry, but it looks like it's pretty much dead. It is on fire, so there's not much left of it. And there are a few things we do have to worry about on this side, but looks like the Tiger's dealing with it. What we will do, though, is we'll get another infantry squad, and we'll move up the center. Which seems to be a place where we definitely have to go. We'll move up the machine gun as well. Just waiting for support, really. Which will be in the form of the infantry when it moves in. And we do have an M3 gun back there. So we do have to worry about that. I mean, all it can really do to a Stug is maybe track it. Because it is only a 45, I believe. Let's have a look. Oh no, it's a 37. Even worse. Well, good luck. Let's just put this guy into position. Aim? Come on. What did you hit? A tree? Oh my god. There we go, that's more like it. Oh, we are getting guys from over here, so we definitely should move the Tiger into position to deal with them. Load AP to actually deal with them instead of looking at it, and hull is destroyed. Basically, just our guns are too good, they're just taking out everything. Instead of just hurting them, which is what I would prefer. Medic, get back. And sorry, I do have quite a cold right now. So that's probably why my voice sounds weird and why you can probably hear my breathing a bit more. But anyway, with that all done and dusted, we will move forward through the center. There really isn't a lot left. I mean, there are a few troops that we do have to worry about, but nothing massive. That's really going to hurt us. We can move up all of our guys, just to make it easier for our infantry to move in. We basically want to take this part, and then from here we can stage some kind of counterattack or something like that. Not even counterattack, just a stable position to attack from. Because, in effect, this whole time we're attacking, so there's no, you know, there's no counterattack or anything like that. If they were going, if anything, they are going to counterattack. There is something over here that seems to be quite large, but I don't know what it is. That could be a worry. But it looks like we have cleaned them out in this area, so we'll push up with our infantry squad. Our machine gunner will go over here, and our mortar will push forward. Lovely jubbly. Let's see what's over here. Where is it? It might just be a collection of men, but it looks like a vehicle. That gun's back up and operational and been destroyed straight away. That poor gun. It's got quite a lot of flak, which is bad for us. These guys are slowly but surely running out of ammo. Something we do need to do is bring in an ammo truck. Or a supply truck, just to supply our troops as they move forward. We don't want them running out. And this guy's died once again. Come on, Pudgy. Kill them all, Pudge. Kill them all. Well done. We do have a guy over there that we do have to worry about. But not terribly worry about him. Just more like he's more of a minor annoyance than, oh god, we have to deal with him right now. Please save us. We'll move up our Stug. We'll move up our Tiger to this side of the streets, basically giving us cover for both sides. Whereas, instead of just having cover for one side, we can cover each of the vehicles by using the other vehicle, which is very nice. We'll set these guys up here, in a better position to shoot from. And that supply truck should be around somewhere. Hello, good to see you. Let's push you up. We will need another infantry squad at some point, so we might as well bring them in. And we'll just push you up. Brilliant shot. At least hit the damn guy if you're going to fire an 88 HE at him. Oh my. So the big guns we have to worry about seem to be quite far back. There are some on this side, so pushing down this point should be actually be quite easy to do. We'll get our guys pushed up here. Looks like our Tigers found some friends that it'll kill. And that's all we really have to do. There's a lot of infantry members around here. Our tank commander has been shot off, probably by a sniper, because he can't keep his beaky head inside the turret. But hopefully he's up pretty soon. The machine guns are going absolutely rampant on that, so that's something to think about. Somehow Charlie is down again. Come on, brother. Stop getting shot. Or at least shoot faster than they shoot you. Oh, it's a sniper. Unlucky Charles. There he is. Right, so we can get him now. No. Get him up. It's right there, Charles. Good shot, right, so that's the sniper taken out, so he shouldn't really get shot off anytime soon. Our tank commander has biffed it, so it's definitely time to get him back up. Or just die, you know, one of the two, because our guys are too lazy. We need to get another guy for a replacement. So that's what we'll do. And our infantry in the center are hopefully willing to move forward. We've got the machine gunner up as well. We're slowly but surely taking out all these guys. I mean, there is a lot of them. That's a Chaffee, so good luck with, you know, everything. Not sure how well you're going to do against a Tiger and a Stug, but you know, that's your business. Track damage, main gun damage, turret damage, yeah, you're already out for the count. Hull is pierced on the second shot, third shot, engine damage, goodbye, good night, good sir. So we have this group over here. Let's just push them forward. Try and clear out this area, which seems to be full of damn commandos, which is very much annoying. And this area as well, which is going to be the bloody bane of my existence, if I don't do something about it. It seems like they are pushing forward though, which is very nice of them, meaning that I can shoot them all. But if we clear out this area, it means that we basically have a clear view of that. And that Chaffee really did struggle, didn't it? we do have machine guns over here that we actually should set up, so get some Car 98 boys to do that. And where's the other one? Right in the center. Not really sure about that position, but I'll take it. It'll be good at taking out all these guys who are around here. Or at least put covering fire on them if he decides to shoot. Really up to him, though. I'm not pressuring him into anything. Not today, anyway. Maybe tomorrow. He might have to lead the offense on Stalingrad. I mean, why not? You know. Throw that there to get that guy to move, and we'll push up. Looks like they're shooting us through houses, which isn't very nice of them. But there's one guy dead, two guy dead. And there's the last guy around there. That's a good hit on them, so we'll just move around. We should be able to take them out pretty swiftly. As long as they don't turn this gun, that's one of the biggest issues. One of them is dead, so they won't be able to turn it. And the second guy who was on that gun is now dead. So that point is basically free bacon right now, so we will take it very, very soon. You need to be repaired. And that's exactly what we'll do. After taking out that sniper, this guy's actually had quite a nice day. So I think we'll just keep it like that. Any units moving up are just getting absolutely destroyed by anything. This has been repaired, which is nice. Get back in it. We only need one guy in it right now, so that's all we'll use. Move him to over here. It looks like some artillery pieces trying to hit him, probably the ones right at the back. But we can bring in a Goliath. Whoop-de-frickin-do. What we will do, though, is move to this point. Hopefully there's nobody on it. And take it for our own. Looks like we get some kind of tank from here. Nothing that will rival the Tiger. But it's still nice to have the pointers. It's a victory objective, so you know. Something we are going to have to deal with is this disgusting mess over this side, so we'll bring in some more infantry and we'll push forward with them. They can be supported by all these guys. We got additional resources, which is lovely of them, including a Panzer IV Aus H, so that can push that side. Something that we do need to do is resupply these guys, so we'll get on that ASAP. We also want to give stuff to the Tiger, just to make sure it doesn't run out. This got hit. What the hell hit it? I have no idea. That's completely fine. It's not the end of the world. We will push our troops through here, seems like the most logical place. So they don't get attacked straight away. We'll move these guys slightly over here so they'll actually get in range and actually get some ammo. But this guy is doing a bit of a death-defying run, and well, he didn't defy any deaths, so that's a real issue for him. And we'll push these guys up to here just to give a bit more support to our guys who are pushing forward. The Panzer IV H is now going to go over here. I think is a better position for it. And you boys are going to move into a defensive position here. Another thing we do need to sort out is these machine guns over here, so that's exactly what we'll do. We'll set two of them up, as per. Get them sorted. And we can kind of just crossfire these troops in the center. It looks like they tried to send in some tanks. Didn't work too well. Somebody has actually died under our Tiger, but, you know, who really cares? There is a guy on the ground there who we can actually get to, though, so maybe it's worth it. We'll move this back as well so we can get him up, whoever he is. He is a rifleman, so, you know, he's not massive to the cause, but at least it's something. Looks like it was the two guys on the MG, so somebody took them out, which is very sad. But we'll push him up here. And the wonderful tanks of the American army are getting absolutely slaughtered by our Tiger, which makes complete sense. I mean, it's a Tiger against Shermans. It should dominate, and it is dominating. Over here, it looks like there was a gun, but it got taken out at some point. We do have adequate cover for our boys here, so we'll send them in. There doesn't seem to be a lot over here apart from a... Well, there may be a few more than first seen. We have taken a few of them out. Let's see if that kills anybody. It looks like it hasn't. Oh no, it did. Hopefully that wasn't the medic. Nope, the medic's still alive and kicking. So medic, get this guy up. And this guy. Come on, boss. It looks like there's a sniper in the area as well, which is very much annoying. Somebody was actually behind them, which, you know, is a bit odd. But it looks like we have at least gained their attention, which is lovely. A guy actually got behind us there, which is kind of annoying. And it looks like that is what hit our Stug. It's a good hit from the Panzer IV. Very good hit, actually. Hull is destroyed with a HE round. Well, that's a shame. Two guys have been taken out over here, so it's time to get them up. In pretty decent positions in the center of the party. So that's them up. There's another guy over here who has been downed. So, we'll just move over, if we could. And there we go, he's up. And this guy now. It's like a game of, what's that game, like Whack-A-Mole? Where every time they go down, you have to try and get them back up again. We're going to move the squad back just to reheal. They've done quite a decent job. They took out everybody here, so that means moving forward on that point is going to be a lot easier. How's the tank doing? Tank's doing well on... Oh my god. What the hell hit it? Whatever it is, it's burning to a crisp, so it can't be good. We'll get another Panzer IV H into the fold. I'm guessing it was this gun here, this big 76. How are you doing? You're doing well on health, which is nice. So basically the plan is to get a Panzer IV down this road and around. It makes complete sense to me, just because if I get them there, then he can just shoot down here and help everybody down this road. They don't have sufficient cover really right now to shoot and be successful at it, and if they need cover they have to go all the way around. So the better position is behind these. Once the Panzer IV comes in, it should all be sorted, and we'll be able to kill everybody. There is a few issues with this position. It does leave you pretty much open to everything, but right now it's all going all right. It looks like the machine gun was taken out in this area. Mainly, it looks like a house fell down on them, so that's really an issue for whoever was in that house. Sorry about that. We will reimburse you. There is a guy over here somewhere. But anyway, we have... No. I got a weird feeling that there was somebody on that for some reason. But anyway, Panzer IV coming in to deal with all these troops, try and create maybe at least a little bit of cover for our boys in black over here. And something we do need to do is get, once again, another infantry squad so we can push forward down the center. Because right now we're just kind of stagnating. Once we take out this gun, it'll be easy to push forward. There's probably one on this side as well, or in some god-annoying position. But right now, the focus is on that gun. So we'll push down here, we'll actually push through here with the Panzer, and it's turning, so that's wonderful. Shouldn't really be able to shoot us, we shouldn't really be able to shoot it, so we're in a bit of a stalemate now. I can land a shot right next to it, or completely miss, but if I land a shot right next to it, then it should blow the guys off, which is basically what I'm looking for. That's a good hit, but it didn't seem to do anything, so we'll try again. We're killing the people behind it. So is the life of a bloody Panzer. Looks like we've done something to it. The guy seems to be repairing it, so we should try and move up. These guys are low on ammo again, so moving the ammo truck. We'll move up this Tiger with support of the new infantry battalion, which just came in. There we go. And shoot that damn 76. Blow it out of the damn water. Shoot it again. In the face. Well done. Right, now moving up should be easy. We'll get our Panzer over here. Now that that 76 is dead. And we'll basically just move up with the Tiger and the infantry in tow. To give them support and everything like that. But mainly it's the Tiger show right now. Just trying to take everything out as it goes. These guys are going to come under very much heavy fire. And we've spotted the other gun. Hello. There's two guns. Wonderful. It's a good hit. He's hit one of the guns. Can he hit the other one from this position? Probably not. Somebody is shooting the heart of the tiger. Very much unappreciated, sir. But that's kind of just how it goes. The panzer in itself has moved up in a very good position. And we'll move up our guys to match it, to try and get a heavy tank, it looks like. But once we deal with that gun, pushing forward should be absolutely easy. So we'll push up to here, and we should be able to shoot this guy now. Good turret rotation on this Tiger as well. Oh, why can't you hit him? How close is it? Oh, there's a bloody mound in the way. Alright then, we'll push up. How about now? Oh, just got it right, so that's dead. Getting hit by something else, though. It's an M4A3. Sorry about that, M4A3. If I were you, I'd go home. We do have guys flanking our Tiger, so we do have to worry about that. There we go. He's dead. Crew's injured once again. There can't be many men left in that who aren't shell-shocked to death. Track is damaged. But let's bring in a Panther just to make the... make their issues even worse. We got hit by what seems to be an artillery hit there. But we'll just get these guys up. Once again, using the wonderful medic. Who has decided to give up on his duties. That guy's still shooting. I don't know why he's down, but anyway. Can you get this guy? Yeah, you can. There's just somebody still on top of him. Fair enough. Here we go. Track is damaged on this Tiger, which is annoying, but not the end of the world. Just becomes a bit of a stationary gun for now. We'll get a guy out, repair it, as we do, and let's get another infantry squad in to push that right flank. We are pushing hard on the central flank, of course. Central flank? What am I on about? The middle of the damn map. Oh my god. Sometimes my English just doesn't work too well. Push up these guys to here, just to give them a bit more cover, and onto that gun. And you, sir, over there. Our guys are still back here, so we need to push them up pronto. And we'll stick them on the points, just to give it a bit more cover, just in case somebody decides to try and flank us. I am worried about that guy who's next to my Tiger on the left, but... if he wants to throw something, he throws something. I mean, there's not really a lot I can do about it. But with this Panther, with its very good frontal armor, we should easily be able to push up. We do have a 76mm there that we do have to worry about. I'm guessing there'll be one on the other side as well. The Tiger is now repaired. So we're going to push up. We're also going to hit that. You're out of AP, which is a shame. Sorry, you're out of HE, which is a shame. But we'll move up. Give you some stuff, you know how it is. Good shot. Hitting our men straight in the face, that's what we need. It's a good morale boost. And hopefully, we should be able to shoot that guy. It's going to be a tough one, though. Like, it's... the shot in itself is a rough one. That's... nope, no way. Alright. And... there we go. He's getting HE, which is wonderful. That gun is taken out, so we don't have to worry about it now. We'll just let the Tiger gain some lovely ammunition before we move forward. And you guys are our new battalion of Suicide Squad. Which do... is that tank alive? Can we take it? Repair! Can't let a 76 Sherman go begging. Absolutely wonderful tank. Not against Tigers or Panthers, but overall pretty decent. We'll put these guys here, just so we can push them forward. For some reason, I can't put them on the damn sandbags. But there we go. The Tiger in itself is going to push forward, try and sort out as many troops as it can now, since it has HE rounds. There we go. That's a good hit. And just mow them all down. Do your Tiger thing. It's like just instant, you know, instant death when the Tiger comes around. Something we do need to do is repair this, just to make it full again. Even though it's completely operational with all of the stuff wrong with it, it's still better to get it into a position where it isn't like that. for obvious reasons. This guy decided just to dive out on my tiger, so I hope he's happy with himself. I wouldn't be. Come on, Boyle. But we do need to deal with this gun. And we still don't have a shot from it over here. So, Panther. Let's see, somebody's been shot out. So you get back in, Tank Commander. There's no slacking in this army. And push up you to here. Take out you. And we don't have great armor, but we have good enough armor. But you gotta hit him. Did you hit him? No way. First shot? Not bad. But what I was going to do with the squad in the first place was actually push down here, so that's what I'm going to do. Try and take this point. The center is basically locked down right now. The only people attacking the center are morons with rifles trying to kill a tiger. So riddle me that. Move up to the supply truck, which got destroyed. So we'll get this guy up. And bring in some supply trucks. Or at least one. To help us out. It's a good hit, you missed. Let's try again. Oh, it's a damn jumbo. What do we have? Stone Tiger, yep. Sorted. Something went horribly wrong with this Panther. But his crew is injured. Tiger's got a track out. Both of the things have a damn track out, so that's absolutely wonderful. Engine is damaged, meaning that it would blow eventually. But something that we do need to look at is, first of all, repairing this. Second of all, getting our medic over here to get these guys up. There we go. Because I believe we have a tank commander down, who is now dead, but we also have an SMG dude down that we do have to worry about. The supply truck is nowhere near here. And it looks like our tank commander from this tank got shot off once again. Turn the turret. Fire at will. Come on. Let's go over here, get this guy up. It looks like we're kind of chasing pigeons here. We're going between people. We're not really getting a lot done. The engine is damaged on something. I don't think it's the Greyhound, though. I think it was the Sherman behind it. At least we got this guy up, which is wonderful, and we got this guy up too, so hopefully that should repair our vehicle. The Panther is repaired, so we'll get you guys in there. We'll push you guys up to here to take this point, and the Panther will just push down the road. We should have a Sturm Tiger somewhere. Oh, here you are, you big fat slob. Let's go. Move up. We got all these guys back just to give them a bit of ammunition. They've had a hard day. They've had to go through a lot. We have two medics here, which is weird, but okay. We have actually taken this central point, and you need to get back in. And now we just have to push down this place, which is going to be interesting. We're getting hit by 76s. Which isn't terrible. We can easily take them out with one shot. With the Sturm Tiger coming in, the Sturm Tiger is going to be absolutely brilliant at killing stuff like that. We also have some 76s coming in to deal with our Panthers and Tigers and Yag Panthers and Sturm Tigers. Let's just say I don't give much to the confidence that they shouldn't really have. But anyway, our guys are getting sniped, of course, because, well, welcome to Men of War. So we'll get them up. You guys need to move back so we can actually get to this dude who is now dead. Wonderful. How much have you been hurt? Not really at all. What are you getting shot by? It seemed to be that. And now it's dead. Hull is damaged on that. Let's get a HE shell into the 76. The Tiger is cleaning up. 166 infantry kills and 22 vehicle kills. Hell yeah. It's doing absolute madness right now. We need to move up an infantry squad to support our tanks in the forefront. We've actually created a block of dead things, which is a shame for the dead things. But we are going to fire a Sturm Tiger shot over the house. Hopefully it goes over the house. And are you going to go bibbidi bobbidi boo? Or are you? Nope, you're not. Alright, well, we're going to have to go into a a better position. It looks like they're throwing everything they have at us right now, which, to be honest, isn't a lot, especially since we have a Jagdpanzer, or a Jagdpanther, sorry, coming in, which is going to do a hell of a lot of damage. Get the Sturm Tiger into a position where it can actually shoot the Field Howitzer, and it feels comfortable doing it, and there we go, there's the rocket, and no explosion, which was a bit odd, but it did destroy that, which is fine. I'm okay with that. Good trade, good trade. Let's get you back in so you can actually man the gun on top. Something we need to do with this Panther is the same thing we have to do with all of our vehicles, is try and get the tracks sorted, because they can't pen anywhere apart from the damn tracks, so the tracks keep coming off. Have we actually repaired this vehicle? Yes, we have, right. Well done, lads. Get in. Let's get this rolling. We have a 76 on our side, which is always wonderful. The Jagdpanther is here. It will support this guy on this side. Oh, there's a gun right there. That may have been an issue. I thought I'd killed that. Hull is destroyed on the Panther. I don't know what shot it, but it shot it hard. But that gun is now dead, so we don't have to worry about that anymore. We do have to worry about the fact that we have a dead Panther. And I have no idea what hit it, and I'm kind of scared of what hit it, actually. The Sturm Tiger needs repairing, so let's set that up. Something we do need to sort out now, then, to get the Jagdpanther on this side, and also, let's get the 76 moving. Let's get the 76 in here as well. Main gun is damaged. So the Sturm Tiger is basically out of action right now, but with our other tanks we should be able to push forward. It looks like we've taken out basically all of the tanks that they had. All they really have is infantry. And our infantry is actually doing pretty well of, you know, staying alive and all that jazz. So we'll push these guys up to here. Once the Sturm Tiger is sorted, we'll be able to push forward. I do want to take out that gun. I thought I took it out before with the Sturm Tiger, but I was obviously wrong. So what I'm going to do is to make sure. And not dead. Shoot again. Crew is injured, which is terrible. Basically means that they're paralyzed. Don't feel like shooting. Vehicle is repaired. Track damage. Main gun damage. Track damage. Track damage. Track damage. Track damage. But the Tiger, in all of its wisdom and glory, is actually back up, which is wonderful. Let's get a guy in here. Let's keep it up to full. Tiger can stop and wait for the guy to get in it. We need somebody manning that gun. And we need somebody hitting that as well. And it looks like it's not going to be any of our boys. Bloody hell. Well, there's 176, which has been the bane of my existence right now. There's also a Greyhound coming in. Wonderful. What do we have back here? We have a 76 to kind of worry about, but not really, especially with the Tiger and how it is. Oh, we have a Panzer IV over here. Okay, go there. Right, you need to shoot this as soon as possible. But you can't hit it. Why can't you hit it? How about now? Brother, come on. Don't fuck with me. Why can't you hit it? Oh, there's some kind of damn wall in the way. Well, you hit the guy behind it. That's all good. Something we need to do is move this guy back so he doesn't get hit by any of those pesky AT grenades that I just got hit by. We're going to take this Panzer. We're going to manually control the damn thing. We're going to kill everything. Go on, get out. No. Oh, didn't work. Did not work in the slightest. And they are all dead. Pointless deaths. Completely pointless. But anyway, our Jagdpanther still needs to be bloody repaired. Sturm Tiger is actually getting there. Once we get the gun sorted, we'll be able to take out all the guys here. Tiger's in a decent position just to keep shooting everything. It's once again out of HE, which is a real issue, but it has killed 189 men and 25 vehicles. We have lost our supply truck once again, so that's something we do need to bring in. Panther is pretty useless right now. Basically everything is pretty useless. I mean, we have the resources to push forward. The issue is all of our tracks have been taken off, so it's quite hard pushing forward when you have no mobility and they're facing the goddamn wrong way. So what we'll do is we'll plunk a shot right there. There we go. Bonk. That'll kill all of them. And we'll be able to finally repair shit. Crew is injured once again on this Tiger. It's not having a great day. A lot of AT grenades thrown at us. But we do need to push up slowly but surely. These guys don't have any AT grenades. Wonderful. How about you? Do you? Nope. Oh well. Have fun with your certain death. There's no medic here. Stop telling me there's a medic here. There's the tank. Hull is destroyed on that. And that should be the last tank that we have to deal with here. Doesn't seem to be a lot more. There seems to be a lot of troops, which can be machine gunned down. We have our Sturm Tiger, which still needs to get repaired. Bloody repair the gun. It got shot again. My god. But the Tiger in itself is just going to take everybody out. And, that should be Sailor V, really. It's a good hit on the gun there. Track is damaged because it shot straight through it. Obviously there's not a lot of metal on those damn things. We're going to throw a grenade at this just to make it easier for our Tiger. Good throw, good toss. That should take them out. And bang, good stuff, right. So you go here. Supply trigger's here, which is nice. Get these guys resupplied. Once this guy's taken out, we'll push forward. There we go. So we're attacking them from both sides with a Tiger as support, which is always nice, especially when you're infantry. These boys have been taken out in droves though, which is definitely an issue. And we now have no machine guns for the Tiger. Sturm Tiger is back up though, so we'll chuck it over there. All it has is AP shells. So we may just want to bring it back. I mean, it has done a very good job. We'll give it everything at once, and we'll push forward once again with this. I suppose that gun is still alive. And there goes the Tiger. Oh well, it did well. We don't really need it anymore. I mean, we have a Yag Panther. And we're slowly but surely taking out all the troops. This guy can probably do a mad dash and try and take that. So can you boys. Let's just do a mad dash. See if we can take it. There is only one man on it after all. There we go. There's a bunch of men coming in from over here though. That we do have to deal with. Go on, Yag Panther. Do your best. Where is my Sturm Tiger? Oh my god, it's tracked again. I don't even know why I bother. But anyway, we are taking the last point. Even though we haven't killed all the troops. We've done a really good job at basically encircling this last point. I mean, I wish we could have done it a lot more cleanly. But to be quite honest, we had the troops to push through without doing it cleanly. So what's the point? But there we go. 798 men killed. 46 vehicles led to their death by the Americans. And friendly losses, we did lose quite a lot of men and 15 vehicles. So I'm not happy with that, but a win is a win at the end of the day. I'll catch you next time.